Hello again, this is video number 2 for respiration process. We already discussed that why in multicellular organism diffusion is not enough for helping in respiration. So in any multicellular organism, they have devised different organ system to make possible of this respiration. For example, in plants, we have learnt about stomata and lenticels by which very easily the exchange of gases take place. In young roots also, the presence of root hair also helps in the exchange of gas. When we talk of animals, we will find a wide diversity of the method of respiration in organisms like fishes, earthworm, frog, insects and mammals like human. In fishes, it is known as the respiration where dissolved oxygen is taken inside the body. So in this respiration, basically what is going to happen is, let us see a diagram of fish. Now, you can see the diagram of fish over here. So oxygen which is dissolved in water, dissolved oxygen, that means enters into the fish body through the mouth. Have you seen a fish opening its mouth continuously after a fraction of a second? It is not having only water, it is taking basically dissolved oxygen in the water. So this water will move and reach to the gills of the fishes. So gills are thin respiratory membranes through which, when the water containing the dissolved oxygen will pass, it will absorb the oxygen and help it to pass to the other different cells. Now during this process, CO2 will also be produced. CO2 that is produced in the body will be dissolved in the water that is moving inside the fish water, and finally through a structure called as operculum, it will come out of the body of the fish into the outside. Now, I have written faster rate word over here. This means that if you see the rate of respiration, of rate of inhalation or taking in of oxygen in fishes is very large as compared to humans. It is because the concentration or amount of dissolved oxygen is in water is very less when compared to terrestrial organism taking it from atmosphere. So what is going to happen if there is less oxygen? For taking the same amount of oxygen, it has to breathe faster. So for 1 ml of the same oxygen, it has to take it inside at a faster rate. But humans will have to take it at lesser rate to take the same amount of oxygen. So this is very, very important as an NCERT question. Now, this was about fish. In the case of earthworm, earthworm does a cutaneous form of respiration. Here, cutaneous means respiration through skin. Now, its skin can respire, but humans cannot do it because the earthworm skin is acting directly like a respiratory surface. It is very thin and having a fine surface. It is delicate. It is having mucus or moisture. It is directly supplied with blood capillaries. It has large surface area. These things are not present in our skin, so we cannot respire through the skin surface. When we talk about frog is very special because in the tadpole stage, it can respire through the gills also. It has gills also. When it is an adult form, it respires through both skin as well as lungs as per the need. In insect, we have done in class 7 the presence of a tracheal system, spiracles or hole-like structures were there in the body that used to help the organism to breathe in and breathe out. And finally, the human beings, we are going to learn about the human respiratory system. So in all of them, all of these organisms, depending on the complexity, certain structure will be acting as a respiratory surface. For example, in fish, the respiratory surface is gills. It is the gills which is known as the respiratory system surface. In earthworm, it is the skin. In the case of frog, it is the skin also, gills also, and the alveoli present in the lungs. In insect, as such, respiratory surface is present inside the body only for protection. In humans, we will talk of again alveoli-like structure in the next diagram. So what is common in all of these structure? The common part is that if certain part of the body has to work as a respiratory surface, it has to be very delicate. It has to be one cell thick. It has to be thin with a fine surface. It needs to have moisture present over it. The blood capillary should be directly in supply with this respiratory surface so that whatever oxygen comes into this surface, it directly goes inside the blood capillaries so that it reaches all the body surface. It has to have a large surface area so that a lot of exchange of gases is possible. Now, similarly, you can see the word pigment over here. Here, the pigment means the carrier of the oxygen. So, for example, the cell has just entered the oxygen over there. What will carry this oxygen from the surface where it has been taken to rest of the body? A carrier must be present. So, carrier is a pigment known as hemoglobin pigment. Globin means a protein. Okay? Hemo means iron. That means iron containing pigment is present. It is important also because it gives the red color to the blood. It is present in the RBC of the blood. Now, let us come to the next slide. The next slide over here basically explains the human respiratory system. Now, as you can see, the human respiratory system starts with nostrils, okay, nasal passage is there, this windpipe, it is also known as trachea, pharynx also is present in the same place. This trachea is supported by C-shaped cartilaginous rings that helps to prevent the windpipe from collapsing at the time of if there is no air in it. For example, sometimes we hold our nose and we do not breathe in and breathe out. So in that time, it may happen that the trachea can collapse because there is no bone structure present in it. So to prevent it, the cartilaginous rings, C-shaped cartilage, which are incomplete rings, which are holding it and it doesn't allow it to collapse. Now, after trachea, you can see this structure, which is known as bronchus. Single structure, bronchus. Now, bronchus is dividing into left. This is the left lung, okay? So, it is the left. And this is the right lung. This is the mirror image. So, you need to understand this is the left and this is the right. Left bronchi, bronchus divided into left and right bronchi. Each bronchi will even branch more and be rebranching into bronchioles. These thinner branches, you can see. These thinner branches are known as bronchioles. At the end of each bronchiole, there is a presence of a small cloud-like structure, bag-like structure. This is the alveoli. Now, this alveoli serve as the respiratory surface in the case of human beings. This is the part through which exchange of gases will take place. Okay, so that is why this alveoli is richly supplied with blood vessels. The diagram we will see very soon in the next slide. Now, this is the left lung and this is the right lung. The lung, both the lungs are covered by a very thin pleural membrane. This pleural membrane has a fluid present in it, which is known as pleural fluid. This pleural fluid acts as the way so that it can absorb any shock. For example, you get an injury or you get a push. It can directly damage the lungs. So to avoid that, this push or this shock is absorbed by the pleural fluid present inside the pleural membrane. Again, to help it to prevent such a problem, the lungs, both sides are enclosed in with ribs. Can you see this ribs present? This is present on both the side. I have made on one only to avoid any kind of confusion. So this is the right lung I can see. And each of the ribs on the side walls of the body is connected by intercostal muscle. Remember it. We'll talk about it in the next slide. So, can you see a dome-shaped structure over here? This is again a cartilage-like structure that can change its shape. This dome-shaped structure over here is called diaphragm. Spelling should be learned because you make a lot of mistakes while doing the spelling part. Can you see? This lung has a small gap over here and it is comparatively smaller than this. This gap is present to give space to the heart, which we have not made till now. That is why this place is known as cardiac notch. So the next part, inhalation, exhalation, we are going to do in the next slide. Thank you.